of this verse, النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. He says, من لم يرى نفسه ملكا لرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ولم يرى ولاية النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام عليه في كل حال لم يكن متبعا لسنته. If you do not know, if you do not believe that you're owned by the Prophet owns your life. You don't own it. He owns your life. It is his. Your life is his. When someone calls you to support Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, the first thing you do is you offer everything you have, let alone your money, let alone everything else. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is prior to everything in this life, before anything else. The Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum loved him more than water when someone is about to die of thirst. And you should see that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has authority above you in every minute of your life. You tell me how, I'll explain to you how. How to witness Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam throughout your life. But this is النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. In one of the readings of the Quran al-Kareem, narrated by Sayyiduna Ubay ibn Ka'ab and Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Abbas, Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, may Allah be pleased with them, it is narrated by two, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Ubay ibn Ka'ab. It reads, هو أب لهم. He is a father for them. Although this is not a valid reading of Al-Quran al-Kareem, but it is a hadith. It is a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is like a father for the believers, for all the believers. For that reason, do you see Rasulullah as a father? A father offering us guidance as we see or we look at our shaykhs as spiritual fathers, because they give us knowledge, which is the tissue of our spiritual life. They give us guidance, which is the means of our survive in al-yawm al-akhir. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the father of all the believers, and for that reason the believers are all brothers. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. We are all brothers because we belong to one father, one spiritual father. He is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And from that point, I tell you, if you do your father good, Allah will give you prosperous life. If you are grateful to your father, Allah will make your business flourish. If you treat your father and your mother, of course, more important than your father, as in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but here we're speaking about Rasulullah being a father. If you treat your parents in the best way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extends your life. You live long, a healthy life. The opposite, the opposite. You do not do good to your parents, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't allow you to live long, or you live long in agony, and your business will not flourish, and your rizq will be less, and you will have to suffer. The key is doing good to your parents, to your father, to your mother. Now, if you do not do good to your spiritual father, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what do you expect your state to be? This is the state of the Muslim Ummah now. One of the most important and crucial questions are why the Muslim Ummah is defeated. People talk about Iman, people talk about Quran, people talk about good character, people talk about a lot of things. Everything is good and everything is correct. But the most important reason is we're not grateful enough to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is why we are defeated. We are not following the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. This is why we are humiliated. We're not loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enough. This is why we live in agony and we are tested day after another. If you want izzah and nasr, you have to support Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Supporting Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the key to our success as an ummah, as an Islamic ummah all together. Because he is the core of our deen. And this is where I started from. النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم. This is why, brothers, there is every reason for us to love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam when we see the favors he extended to us all and to all humanity. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Every human being must love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. If you don't see any of these reasons, then don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves him? You love Allah, then you love, and you must love everything else Allah loves. And the Prophet says in one hadith on the authority of Anas ibn Malik, may Allah be pleased with him, أَحِبُّ اللَّهَ لِمَا يَغْذُوكُمْ بِهِ مِنْ نِعَمِهُ وَأَحِبُّونِ لِحُبِّ اللَّهِ. Love Allah for what he provides you of his bounties. And love me because Allah loves me. If you're blind, if you don't see any virtue, if you don't see anything in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you don't read his seerah, you don't read his life, you don't know his character, you don't know his miracles, you don't know his knowledge, you don't know about his beauty. If you don't know anything else, you haven't learned about any good he extended to you and any favors you received from him, then love him because Allah loves him. There is no level at loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Go and exaggerate as much as you wish. No one has done the ummah as bad as the Saudi royal family has done the Muslim ummah. And the worst thing is taking away from the hearts of the believers the love and attachment to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Every time we go to Hajj, all they speak about is shirk and mushrikeen. Are those 3 million Muslims coming from around the world mushriks? Aren't they believers in Allah? They come there to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no one single Muslim on the face of the earth who believes Rasulullah is God or Son of God or God incarnate. There is no one single Muslim on the face of the earth who thinks that Rasulullah has any divine quality. Rasulullah is a human being other, like all other human beings in terms of his humanity, in terms of his humanity or humanness. But unlike all other human beings, in his characteristics, in his jawhar, in his essence, in his light, in his function as a messenger, in his perfection, in his impeccability, in his sinlessness, unlike all other human beings, all other human beings compared to him are like stones, rocks. And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is like a piece of diamond, a ruby, a pearl. Muhammadun basharun wa laysa kal bashari bal huwa yaqutatun wan nasu kal hajari. We have so many sound hadiths that tell us Rasulullah was different from other human beings. In Sahih al-Bukhari itself you read, Rasulullah used to see from behind. We see with our own eyes. He used to see from behind. He says, فَإِنِّي أَرَى مَنْ خَلْفِي كَمَا أَرَى مَنْ أَمَامِي. I see from behind as I see in front of me. He's a human being. Still, he's a human being. And this is the sound hadith. I'm not talking about weak hadith or strongly weak hadith. I'm talking about things that, which are sound and are undeniable by the consensus of the ummah. Why not highlight the importance of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in our life? Allah in the Quran al-Kareem doesn't say, فَقَدْ سَيَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولَهُ. And that's it. Allah tells us in the Quran al-Kareem in many verses, أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. Obey Allah and obey the messenger. In another verse, أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَالرَّسُولَ. Obey Allah and the messenger. In another verse, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Obey the messenger so that you may be shown mercy. In another verse, إِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. If you obey him, you will be well guided. If you do not, you won't be guided. In another verse, by Allah, by thy Lord, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ. By thy Lord, لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. They won't be believers. حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ. Until they hold you as a judge in all matters which arise amongst them, فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ. ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِمَّا قَضَيْتَ. Then they do not object to anything you decide upon. وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. They submit to you in every possible way of submission. You have to submit to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's sunnah. You have to submit to his commands. Total submission to Rasulullah. As we have total submission in Islam to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have total submission to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his commands. Because of his perfection. In one hadith, one of the sahaba asked Anas ibn Malik, the khadim of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, or another of the Sahaba. One of the Sahaba asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by my father and my mother, O Messenger of Allah, can I write everything you say even when you are angry? He said, by Allah I write everything. Write everything I utter. By Allah I swear, this tongue, nothing comes out of my tongue but the truth. Nothing comes out of my mouth but is true. والذي بعثني بالحق لا يخرج منه إلا حق. By Allah I swear, nothing comes out of my mouth, but it is true. This is why he is perfect, and this is why we have to follow him. So it's not about believing in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.